You have any
Enchanté.
questions before we get started? Because I mean, you've got all your weapons, and it's the
This
three of
guy.
you.
All right. Yeah, you guys. Yeah, I'm ready to go. Am I not going to be able to do any actions unless people tell me to do stuff? Is that a thing that
I
they should
mean,
do?
I assume that Coral will probably tell you, like, let's fight, and then you'll be able to fight.
Yeah,
That's
I'm a
fine.
leader, so you should be. I mean, like, you're property of
All right, so I
Stadium.
just say, awaiting instructions, when we
Wait,
get
can I
up,
just rip this
to the
fucking
thing.
bolt out of your butt?
Yeah.
Yeah, rip that bolt out of your butt.
Okay.
Done.
Oh, fucking thank God. Oh, that's fucking bothersome. I wanted to follow those guys earlier, just couldn't do it. Couldn't.
That's rough.
Oh, people are
And I was
starting
gonna
stream
say something
crashes.
mean to, that actor fellow and couldn't do that either. It was weird.
What were you gonna say?
Was very impolite. I'd rather not bring it up. Only funny in the moment, you see. Let's see here.
All right, so I need everybody
I'm
to
looking
roll
for
for
where.
cool.
Roll for
Oh,
initiative.
cool. Okay,
You roll
initiative
cool.
cool.
I'm going to put
Oh.
rapid reaction on there. So I get
Okay.
an automatic success for strain.
Ooh, that's cool.
And I'm gonna add that right
I need to
here.
remember my talents. Surgeon, grit, resolve,
I
focus.
literally
Wait,
just wrote
we.
it on like a notepad because it's easier to read than all that
Wait, what are
shit.
we? We're just rolling
You're
cool?
rolling your
Cool.
cool skill.
No, nothing else.
Shit. Shit.
Right,
Get
so I
fucked.
got two successes.
Okay. Player, player.
So this is like Hunger Games. We're supposed to kill the other people that are in here, right?
So this first run is just droids. They're just training to see what your skill level is so they can match you up against another team. Oh, you guys are
Just droids, huh,
pieces of
Arthur?
shit.
Fucking insensitive bastard.
I'll admit, I'll take that one.
Yeah,
Coral, you said you got an automatic success on top of what you already had?
so I got two
All right,
successes.
so you guys have 0, 2, 0, 4,
I
2,
still don't understand this turn order, man. I really don't.
E, and they're just rolling one green. Go last. Okay, so all the players go first. What do you guys want to do in the first player spot? Because there's these barricades in front of you. The barricades that you can't see through are ceiling height, and the ones that you can see through are only chest high. So you can
Right.
like get before them and use them as cover.
I do inspiring rhetoric straight up. All
Okay, let's talk
right.
about it.
Take an inspiring rhetoric action. Make an average leadership check, two purple. Each success causes one ally in the short range to recover one strain. Spend one advantage to cause one effective ally to recover one additional strain.
Ooh, I could use
Each
another one.
ally affected by inspiring rhetoric gains one blue die on all skill checks for a number of rounds equal to your ranks in leadership. And my ranks in leadership is now four, so you will get one blue die for free.
Four
Four
rounds.
rounds. Okay.
Damn, that's
All
getting
right, so
good.
roll it.
Yeah, so this is against a two purple check. So I'm going to roll four yellow, two purple. All right. So,
You cause everybody to recover two strain.
Fucking
Beautiful.
yes.
Sweet.
Okay, because some of you might already be strained.
Yeah,
Yeah, I am.
one, yeah. I still
Okay.
have one after that.
All right, so what are you saying, Coral, or what are you doing to
God, pulling the
inspire?
fucking bolt out was enough for me to get a couple strain.
Yeah, so I look around and I turn back and you're like, "What shall we do, sir?" And I'm just like, I reach over and just go, and I just pull it out and I'm just like, "Boys, we're gonna fuck up some goddamn stupid drones." No offense, Toby. I hand him like the restraining bolt. And
Sir,
I'm just like,
it's worthless now. You've broke it.
Okay. And then I just toss it, and I'm just like, so here's what we need to do. Apparently there's a flag. We need to find it. We need to work together as a team. By the way, where is the little girl? Isn't she supposed to be with us?
So the women and Vape are all on their own team. They're not doing full runs all together until you go into corporate competition. They're just testing in small groups right now.
Okay. All right. Okay. And I'm just like, so yes.
That's mostly, it. Again, this is a decision, I don't have to run.
I pick up the thing he threw, and I want to carefully try to break it again. I'm like, can someone give me a hand with this thing? Just grab onto this part while I twist, and then I want to be able to put it back on so it looks like I have it in.
It's definitely broken, so you can put it back in. And
okay. Okay. Yeah. I put it back in.
I just don't want to run four NPCs in this combat swing.
Yeah.
It's really about you guys learning to work together.
Well, not really. I mean,
you can move. I believe you can move close range, right?
I think Coral was more worried about me. And
so this wall right here is close range away, and this wall right here is engaged range away.
Okay. So 40 feet is... So I can move like
that? I don't use the feet meter. I've done everything in Star Wars terms, so...
Okay, so I can go there?
Yep. All right, we have another PC slot here. And how do you go forward? Like talk to me as to how you're moving forward with alacrity.
Well, I...
Do you just stroll forward, or are you, like, shoulder charge? Ah, Han Solo!
Well, I've seen holodeck movies, right?
Yeah.
I do what they do.
You've seen a lot of Imperial propaganda. So the stormtroopers all move forward with their weapons held really high and do, like, the side-to-side motion. Yeah.
I believe a lot of Coral's actions...
It's a pretty good walk cycle.
I believe a lot of Coral's actions are basically just, like, what he thinks other people think he should do in a lot of actions. So if this is like, we're just going to see how good you are at combat, he'd be like, all right, boys, dicks in the dirt. And then he'll like run up and be like, whatever. And then he'll hide against one and be like, oh, army strong, pew, pew. And, you know, that sort of shit. Like, yeah, he'd just be playing the part.
All right.
Like, not that he knows what he's doing, but... Whatever he thinks looks good is how he'll do it.
So, who wants to go next on the player spot?
I'll rush up. And I actually have some, like, droid combat training now. I'm assuming I can move
maybe
up about this
far.
You have
a bit more now that your old programming is active.
I do. Can I make it like all the way up to the other side of the wall?
Yeah, it's just a close range, so it's one maneuver.
Okay. Yeah, I rush up to here.
Okay.
And keep an eye out this way for droidals.
Oh, by the way, I say that I see two droids.
Okay.
I realize that you guys can't see what I see now, because I can't see what Toby says.
Yeah, because it's dark as shit and there's mist everywhere. Yeah. All right, you doing anything else, Toby? Because you've only done one maneuver.
Should have yelled that earlier. I would have fucking touched it. So I can't.
You can
get
do a second
further.
Maneuver if you take two
right.
strain.
By the way, did you recover your fucking strain?
Yeah. I mean, I only have one out of 15 right now. And if you can see them, then they can see you, and we probably need to get shooting.
Yeah. So I mean, there's some antiquated battle droids, like old beat up pieces of junk that are currently crouched behind a barricade getting ready to fire.
Okay, so if I'm here, is there any cover
for either of these? They have cover from you, and as you move around the corner, you see that there's three droids that are behind the wall, and they all immediately pivot their torsos toward you.
Okay, well, I'm going to blast at the closest one, which isn't, like, melee, so I don't get, like, a thing, right? Anything bad. I have my quick strike, so I get an extra blue dice, and I can also suffer one strain to reduce one of his defense die as well.
You also get a second blue die from my inspiring rhetoric. All
right. Okay,
so... Let me check what you're shooting against. I think it's purple. They're at close range with you. And you took the two strain for going around the corner, right?
Yeah, so let's see here. It's going to be ranged heavy. I'm going to get two blue. I'm going to suffer three strain.
What's that about?
Well, one strain for two strain for the maneuver.
Yep.
Right? And then an additional one to lower the difficulty die of the shot.
Okay, you are shooting into short range, so you're shooting against one purple.
No problem. I'm going to fucking wreck this guy.
If you lower the are you downgrading or removing a difficulty die?
Let me just check my skill real quick.
Two very different things.
It is called precise aim. Suffer a number of strain no greater than ranks in precise aim, then reduce the target's melee and ranged defense by that number. Reduce the defense by that number.
Yeah, they don't have any defense die.
So, like, I would have a defense die because of my armor, but things that don't have armor
they don't get, like, defense die from the cover? Isn't that what that is?
So, the ones back here do. But you stepped around the corner. These ones don't have cover towards you anymore.
What I was wondering.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah, no, that's what I was wondering if they
had.
Yeah,
no, you're just
going to
straight up shoot them.
Okay,
yeah, you don't need to precise aim them.
It's one less strain, so I just have a total of
Yep, you're shooting against three. One purple.
Oh, and it is updating as I change it on my sheet. Nice.
Still going to keep using that fucking sheet, huh?
That's because it's so fucking good. So I'm shooting against one purple.
Do it.
What's going on here? Oh, there we go. Ranged heavy. Yeah,
okay.
Destroy.
You tell me what you want to do with this roll. There's a lot you can do here.
You didn't even roll your fucking two blue die, bro.
Yeah, go ahead and...
Oh, wait, what did I... How
well,
did
you
I
have
not
one blue die from Coral, right? Where's the second blue die coming from?
Quick strike.
Okay. Quick strike automatically if they haven't attacked. Wait, why did that not work?
You didn't roll anything.
You and this fucking sheet, bro. That's really good.
Oh, that worked. Okay, so three success. So I hit him for fucking, what, six? Let's go to my fucking thing. It's fucking
damage.
It's
plus
11
two.
Is my damage.
11, so it's
three 13. Is crit, so that means I crit.
No, you
right?
Crit is the advantage die.
It's not chase because it's three advantage.
Okay. So you talk me through this. You can use your triumph to activate a crit.
Oh yeah. Sure.
That?
I'll definitely do that.
Okay.
So I bullet
immediately dies when you crit. They're minions.
Roll. Oh, okay, so I don't need to roll
a
crit on
him?
No,
you don't need to roll. They're minions.
Okay, yeah, so I'm running up, and Coral's like, I see some droids, and I just, like, roll around the cover, and, like, boom, from, like, you know, just a couple feet away, take this one's head right off.
And how much damage do you deal?
It's 11 base damage.
So 13?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you tell me how you wipe out all three of these battle droids.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Wait, how the fuck?
Shit.
Yep. Yeah, I stand around the corner and just start like unloading. Like as soon as like I've already pinpointed their location. So as soon as I'm like the centimeter past the barrier, it's like, you guys see like a huge cloud of smoke billowing up from behind.
No, what happens is,
and like,
Coral, you're just like looking around the corner and you're like, there's two droids there. And then a droid head flies past you.
Yeah, a couple of the other ones like slump to the ground noisily.
How mechanic wise were you able to shoot more than one target?
There are minions, so they pool their health together, but they only have one soak value.
Oh.
So every 4 points of damage you do, you kill one, and a critical automatically kills one minion.
I see. All right, so
you
just
dealt
enough
damage with the critical to take out all three.
It's gang rules.
Yeah, it's
gang
rules.
Okay.
Cool.
Okay.
Yeah, and I'm like, this group's clear. We need to move forward to the next assault wave. And I like point. I'm like, I see another team member, possibly. Is that what that is?
No, that's a mistake. That's
okay. True later. I'm hallucinating again, gentlemen. But no, it's gone. It's fine.
All right, Zane, you're up. What do you want to do?
Well, I guess I move forward. Right? I can move to that wall.
Yes, that is one maneuver to move to close range.
Well, shit. And then another maneuver.
You can take a second maneuver for two strain, and you have an action.
So I guess I can move over here and see.
You could have just moved there in the first place if that's where you want to be.
I mean, it's kind of hard to tell because I don't see anything. So I guess I move forward and I move along the wall and I look to Tolby and I go, what's ahead?
Yeah, and I point. I'm like, behind the short barrier. I can see two of them.
Don't see any barrier.
Do you want to ping for him?
Yeah.
He knows what direction to go in.
Okay.
He can't see anything. So it's... Can you see my ping in the dark?
Yeah, I see it. I saw it in the dark.
So
it's over here. So
how far can
I'm
you
pinging
see right
the
now?
Corner of the wall, and then I'm pinging the direct location of them behind.
Can I can I look over the wall?
I just hold up my arm and flip
this,
open the pad
right
and show
here,
them
Zane,
what I can see. Is that
this,
cool?
This wall goes all the way up to the ceiling.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So then I'm gonna. Can I swap
since
places
he's
with Toby?
Since he's right behind me,
yes,
I just
you
like,
can,
show him?
You can show
a video?
Him on your data pad.
Yeah.
They're around
I
the corner.
Show you my
if
feed.
If you want to take another move, Zane, I can put you close to where they are, and you can figure out where you want to end at.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So you would end up at their next barrier up here.
Okay. Yeah,
so
sure.
So they're already behind it in defensive position.
Yeah, so up. I'll wait on that barrier, and I'll kind of stay ready around this corner.
Okay. All right. You need to take two mode. Strain for a second maneuver, and you still nice. Have an action if you want to do anything.
I can't do anything.
You could shoot them.
Yeah, they have cover, but you can still
over the
them.
Wall? They have
so this wall is only chest high, and they've got their guns out, and they're shooting it.
Oh,
the ones you
one's...
can't see through, the ones where the dynamic
that's
lighting
the
is
way.
Blocking you,
gotcha.
Is a wall.
Cool. Yeah, so then yes. Yes, I will shoot.
Then let's do it.
If I can remember how to do that.
You're shooting against
heavy.
One purple.
Okay.
Heavy something.
Oh, so it's literally the skill, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Whatever your blast. Weapon uses, which is probably going to be ranged heavy if you've got a rifle.
Yeah.
It's a bowcaster, yeah. Right?
It's one versus one purple?
Yep.
Sweet.
another fucking crit.
Yeah.
Man,
you tell me what you want to do with this.
Purple.
You could blow that crit on this dude right in his face.
Yeah, I just pop up in the bullcaster.
Oh, plus he had a fucking blue. It doesn't even matter, though.
Oh, you know what, Toby? That reminds you. You have two advantage die loose. If you wanted to toss a blue die at somebody, or
I'll take a strain back.
Okay. Yeah.
You already had the strain recovered.
He took more strain because he charged forward.
Yeah.
Oh.
So I can get just one back per round,
yep.
Or can I?
Yeah, one back. So Zane, you tell me how you want to spend this. You got an
roll,
advantage die.
Roll a blue die
how much
the way.
Damage? Well, let's start first. How much damage does your weapon deal?
10.
All right.
Plus
so
2
deal...
for point blank, so 12.
And then you have two more, so you deal 14.
Roll a blue die.
Yeah, and you have a blue die from Coral, so you can.
And I have to roll it.
Okay.
1B.
Okay. You deal enough damage to blow away both of these droids, even without using a critical.
And we're trying to get to a flag at the bottom side of the map as fast
yep.
as possible.
Yep.
Okay.
So you have one advantage and one triumph. If you want to open up your book to page 206, you can figure out what you want to spend it on.
What about the reference sheet?
Yeah, the reference sheet has it.
Okay, yeah, it should be on there.
Where on the reference sheet is it?
For using crits?
Yeah, spending advantage and triumph in combat is what.
Spending additional successes if I okay, astrogation, blah 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 blah.
Ooh, perform an immediate free maneuver. Oh, but you already did two maneuvers this turn.
No, you can do an extra. Oh yeah, you can't exceed the two maneuver limit. That's why. Yep.
Negate defenses. No. Ignore penalizing environment.
I don't understand what I'm looking at, but okay.
Is bad visibility partially...
I mean, do you have the book?
No.
Shouldn't I have extra visibility, Arthur? Because the fogginess wouldn't affect me.
I don't know. Why wouldn't it affect you?
Because I have my super expensive vision upgrade suite.
Okay. Well, then... well... Oh, yeah, that's right. You do have that.
Upgrade an ally's character's next check. That's pretty damn good. Like, you go from, like, a someone can put a green to a yellow...
There you go, Toby.
A yellow.
Turn a grand to a YOLO. Oh, yeah. There we go.
All right, so, Swag, you got the reference sheet?
Yeah.
You want to go to page just down... You want to open up page 17?
Yeah, that's where I'm at.
Yeah, so basically, you see how it says
Per, like, at the top, I'm looking at the far right one, right? Right?
Yeah. Oh, wait. Hang on. There is one.
Am I just, like, reading any of those that I can do?
No. There is a shooting one. Where is it? I'm trying to find it.
Oh, there's a shooting one?
Yeah. There is.
Scroll up. Scroll up a little bit.
I mean, there is one that you can, you know, recover on strain. Add a blue to the next active check. Notice a single important point in the ongoing conflict. Activate a weapon quality.
So scroll. Yeah, you want to go to page 19. It's the very last one.
Okay.
And then it'll say, examples of spending advantage or triumph in combat.
Vital, yada, 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 yada. Don't need a crit.
God, I gotta
keep
this page open.
Gain range defense. Ignore penalties. Activate blah, blah, blah. Activate blah, blah, blah. Perform an immediate free maneuver that you have not already performed. Blah, blah, blah. Notice a single important point. Recover one strain. I'm going to recover a strain, I guess.
All right, you can spend an advantage to do that. What do you want to do with the triumph?
Well, fuck. Can I recover two strain?
You should have recovered strain already.
Maybe selected more than once, so yes.
But you should have recovered two strain.
He also did a double maneuver here, so he's...
Yeah, I took two. I took one.
He can recover both of them. So tell me how you run all the way across the arena and blap both of these dudes, and then you come out and you're like, whew, that wasn't very hard at all. You tell me.
Yeah, I like just look back and I go, wink. We got this. Head on towards the flag, quick!
I like tap my like visual sensors, and I'm like, "Oh, now I see the flag. It's straight on, basically right in front of you, Zane." I don't see any other. Oh no, there we are.
So what happens, Toby, is while you're talking, four of the droids come up from the floor. Like the floor opens, and they come up with a repulsor lift elevator, and they come out blasting. They all begin moving towards Zane.
All right, and I'm like, Coral, look out! They're coming right at Zane.
All right, Zane, do you have any defense die on your armor?
I don't think so.
You have lamented, right? Like, what type of armor did you take?
Oh God.
I think we took the one before. The fucking
heavy-plated armor.
Laminated.
Okay, so laminate. Let me check out my.
So they have
three soak.
That's it. No armor. Cool. Yep.
Okay, if you don't have any defensive abilities at all, they're just going to march forward in formation. And as they're moving, they're just shooting a wave of heavy blaster fire at Zane. And they're going to hit. And they're going to critical as well.
Ouch.
All right, Zane, you're going to take 9, 10, 11 stun damage.
That'll fuck you up. But you got soak, so you take 3 away from that.
I have 6 soak.
Oh, 6? So you take 6 away from that. You have 6 soak?
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
Okay, That's and crazy. I need to open up the critical chart here to see what happens when you get stunned.
Wait, 2 was a critical?
They have 3.
Oh, three. Three.
Yeah. So there are weapons that have
stun damage. Okay.
Yeah, that should be. It's the stun damage is going to your strain.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
It's so brutal.
Okay, 63. Can you mark down on a notepad somewhere real quick, Zane? You are slightly dazed. You have a 2 purple. Critical wound, which you're going to have to get healed later, and you are disoriented until end of encounter.
Oh my god.
Well, let me see what disoriented does.
I've been dazed and confused.
Also true.
Alright, you gotta repeat this shit to me, because this is like math class.
You have a 2 purple critical wound.
2P wound.
2P wound that needs to be healed by a doctor. You are disoriented. You add a black die to all checks for the remainder of this encounter.
Okay.
Awesome. Yeah, so they come out the booth. How far is your strain down right now?
Half.
All right, so yeah, they're just firing blue ion bolts at you all over the place, and it's like, pew, 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 and you're just, you know, You're standing because you just shot over the thing, and you're getting tagged by like a dozen of these tiny little sting bolts.
Yeah, I'm getting like my armor is getting like just like hammered, and I'm just like taking a lot of heat. All Toby. Right.
So that's short, medium, and long. So let me just work it out here. Yes. So that one is going to do that, and that, that. Yeah, we'll wait on that. Okay, players, you're up. What do you want to do?
Is there any of them that haven't shot?
All of the ones on the field have shot.
Okay, so Carl looks really happy for a moment. He slides out this glistening new pistol he has, and he twirls it around.
You hear a female voiceover as this goes into slow motion, and it's just like, I prefer this pistol over all its leading competitors.
It's a one-of-a-kind make, handmade for every person that orders.
You know what? I feel like this scene, you're trying to act really cool, but what actually happens is the Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater scene where Snake is just like, yeah, this is a beautiful weapon. Look at how it's shaved down the side. Oh, yeah. Look at the action on this thing is great. And everyone's like, this dude is getting excited sexually over a pistol.
Yep, I know the exact scene you're talking about. So, you guys are going to like this. This pistol is very well acclimated to Coral. Very well acclimated. So, here is what I roll when I shoot. What am I shooting against?
They are not using the wall as cover right now. Mm-hmm. So, it's just 1P.
All right. So, I roll my light range, which is 2 yellow, 1 green. On top of that, I roll 3 blue.
And what's that from?
2 accurate on my pistol and 1 from my leadership thingy.
Okay.
And I have an automatic advantage when I shoot.
Okay.
And you said what? That's from having a... I forget what the actual upgrade is called, but it is from, where is it? Superior pistol.
Okay.
Yeah. You said 1 purple?
You could buy a small starfighter for the amount of money he sunk in his pistol.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, 1 purple.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
This pistol's worth everybody else's equipment combined.
I crit.
Okay. Tell me what you want to do with this. You actually crit twice if you want to.
Yeah. So basically what happens is I pull it out. I do the revolver ocelot sort of like, you know, flick once. And then so it also has 4 pierce as well.
Okay.
So, yeah, I will use the...
So with 4 pierce, they don't have any soak.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's good. Just to make sure that I do it correctly. And it's 9 damage. Is that with a crit? I don't know what the crit is on this thing. Yeah, let me look it up.
By default, most of them are 3.
No, it is 3. I know that. Yep. But I don't know what does it do damage wise on a crit.
I roll on a table. Okay. Except it's a minions, so a crit automatically kills one. Okay. So if you want to spend the triumph and the 3 advantage, not that I'm forcing you to, but if you want to spend the triumph and the 3 advantage, you can instantly kill 2 of them.
And what? Then that's not enough to kill all 4?
Well, then we do damage to see if you kill the rest of them.
Oh. Okay. Well, let's do damage first, and then because I might want to spend that triumph on something.
Sure. Let's talk about it. How much damage are you doing?
9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Okay, 13. So you're going to kill 3 of them.
And then with 1 crit, with the 3.
You're using the 3 advantage to do a crit? Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, you take out the last one. So, yeah, how are you blaster firing all these dudes down? Is it, like, a quick spray? Are you, like, pew, 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 pew? Or are you just, like, bam? You're VAT shooting. Bam, bam, bam.
Nah, it's just one shot, man.
You can't take out four things in one shot, buddy.
Yeah, I can.
You're like, no, Arthur, the dice say I can. Yeah. All right, you tell me exactly how one shot takes out four different guys.
So I see a reflective thing around the corner, and I'm like, oh, man. No, I don't. It's just one shot each. Just bam, bam, bam. Bam.
Oops. I was about to say, you're missing one.
Yeah.
Yeah, you kill four of them.
And I have one additional advantage, which I'm going to use to recover my single strain that I have.
Oh, that's right. Your gun gives you an auto advantage. Okay.
Yeah.
And then you still have a maneuver and a second maneuver if you want.
Can I do three maneuvers?
Yeah, you can only do two.
Well, no. I mean, no, a free maneuver. So instead of using strain,
you spend all of your advantage.
I still have a triumph.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
So I can move
maneuver
to...
and your regular maneuver. Yep.
Can I move to there?
You can move to that. From one barrier to the next is close. And then can you see that barrier to the southwest?
Yeah.
All right. It is medium range from there to there. So you could get halfway in between it.
And if I take two strain...
You've already performed it. So you've performed one maneuver to move from one barricade to the next. There's no way for you to make it to the next one the full way.
Like that.
So you're going to remain in the open? Okay.
I can't see what's on the other side. I don't know where this flag is. I can't see it anyway.
Yeah. Again, remember, it's night. It's dark and there's smoke everywhere.
All right. Well, in that case, I'd probably just stay there.
Okay. Yep, that sounds wise. Anything else?
Am I able to take like a stance to not get hit or something?
Yeah, you can spend your second maneuver to interact with the environment and like get a defense die from the from the barrier, right? You can hide behind this wall type
thing. Let's do that.
All right. Second PC, what do you want to do?
I'm going to run forward as far as I can. Do you want to just
Yeah, if you want to use two maneuvers, you can maneuver medium range to there.
Okay.
It's going to take you two strain to do that.
Okay, that's two full maneuvers and no other actions. Yep. Yeah. Okay, I'm just like, I got him spotted at the next barricade. Straight ahead, boys. Quite a distance, though. Two more strain.
It's long range to shoot from where you're at to the next barricade.
But I can't take more than two actions.
You can't take more than two maneuvers. You still have an action if you want to shoot.
Oh, I do still have an action. Okay.
So every round you have an action and a maneuver, and you can take a second maneuver for strain. So you've used two maneuvers.
I still have an action. Okay.
Yep.
So I'm like, they're over in this direction. And then I'm going to blast at this one that I can just barely see, like, his elbow sticking out. Where is my... Okay, skills. Range heavy, one purple. And I have one blue from my my weapon upgrade. So one purple is all I'm shooting against? Or no, this guy is behind.
You know what? I'm sorry, Toby. It actually is only one maneuver to move to medium range. You don't need to take that strain yet.
Oh, great.
Yep.
That means I can get off more shots.
My apologies. And actually, Coral, if you wanted to move ahead, you could as well.
To the other?
Yep. You could move to the barricade that Toby's currently behind.
Oh, that sounds good. Move me up there.
My bad, guys. Thank you for correcting me, chat.
Can you move me up there? I can't see it.
Yes, I can.
Cool. I can't see what's left of me.
So this guy does have cover, though, right? Oh, but he hasn't shot yet, so I get another blue. Oh, and it's still within four rounds, so I get another blue. Oh, man, they're going to give us a fucking S rank.
I think you can only see one of them, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
This
does he have cover? Does he get a black for that?
Oh, yeah, he does. Yeah. You're shooting against... And this is long range, so the difficulty is greatly increased. Make sure your weapon is even capable of shooting long range.
Yeah, it's a heavy blaster.
Does it say medium or long?
I reckon that'd be medium, bro.
Blaster rifle, augmented spin.
It should be at the very beginning of the tag. It should say, you know, weapon. It tells you what you use to shoot it with.
It's and medium it tells you range. Said medium, okay. Heavy blaster rifle, right?
Yeah.
So heavy blaster rifles are long.
Heavy blaster rifles long, so you can shoot at them. It's yeah, three great. Purple and one black to shoot at this minion group.
Wait, why do you... Are you seriously have a cumbersome rifle?
Yeah. Three purple, one black. Three blue. Two yellow and a green.
Where's the three blue come from?
One from my upgraded weapon.
Right.
Which I forgot last time. One from Henley.
Yep.
And where was the other one coming from?
Well, did you what give yourself that? Another
die? Oh, they haven't acted yet. They haven't acted yet.
Oh, there you go. All right, let's shoot.
I can spend a strain to get an extra one.
All right, let's shoot. Sorry, guys. We do not do many combats, and this is actually the session where we're learning to do tactical combat together because we've never done a combat that lasted more than one
Boom.
Session.
Boom, it's a hit.
Okay. Yeah, wow. That was
do you really have an tough upgraded, for you. Did you have an upgraded gun? Like, do you have a superior gun?
Yeah, he already put the die in for that.
Yeah.
Tell me what
it
you want to do.
It does have one pierce, which I forgot last time, too.
Okay, that's good.
I want to recover strain because I keep on spending it.
Okay.
So well, I mean, if you strain. Have a if you have a superior rifle, you get one advantage.
Yeah, he already added that.
So then you would have enough for a crit right now.
I think a superior weapon gives you an extra blue die, right?
No, a superior weapon gives you a one advantage die, success automatically.
Okay, well then, yeah, you would have rolled one less die.
No, because I mean, I know I have the spin barrel.
Okay,
which gives
that's two damage, accuracy mod, and a piercing mod. So I don't.
You don't have superior then?
No,
yeah,
I just.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Accuracy would give
you then you damage. Tell me what you want to do. You're taking two strain off, and how much damage does your weapon deal?
It's doing 11.
And it has
no extra
no
successes.
Soak. Oh, I'm sorry. It has one pierce.
Has one. Yeah.
Okay. So you lower the soak to 3. So they're taking 8. So tell me how you're shooting around the corner. You see one of them, and somehow two explode. You tell me.
Yeah, I like, first I like, my first couple shots that I shoot off are off a little bit, and they're just hitting, like, the very edge of the wall, and then I figure if I just shoot there, like, 5 or 6 more times, I'll blast a hole through that part of the wall, because it's already weakened, okay. So I just lay heavy fire into it till I blast through the wall, and then when I hear the explosion, I, like, stop firing to check. Okay. Oh, got one!
All right, Zane, you're up.
Can I just shoot? I can kind of see them.
Yes, see them it the is fog. Long range.
Which bowcaster has medium range.
But you're not capable of shooting.
So can I just run up with...
You could use two maneuvers to move to
actually,
long range.
I can't. I realized that I need
one maneuver to get like here and then...
I need one maneuver to use my bowcaster shit.
To do what?
To fire the bowcaster.
That's your action is to fire the bowcaster.
But it has that feature on it or whatever.
Oh, what
yeah, I must
is it
at
called?
Least I must at least take a maneuver to.
Oh fire. Really? Yeah. Then
to
I mean,
reload.
Just maybe it might be reload. I'm not sure.
You have an auto recocker though.
Do I?
Remove reloading maneuver requirement. Yes, we bought this for you.
Yeah.
Nice.
Where did I put that?
That's great. That means you can move and shoot.
Yeah, you're like, I gotta reload this thing, and then you see it like go back and like
auto recock.
Yeah, automatic recocker. Yep, and we got you two upgrades for it. We got you the accelerator enhancement, and we got you the recocker.
Yeah, the gun says in Wookiee, "Gun is ready to fire," but it sounds like.
What is the accelerator enhancement do?
You've got an extra 2 damage. You got a 2 weapon, so and you got 2 pierce.
So you got an extra 2 damage and 2 pierce on it. You need to write them down somewhere.
God. Where did I put these?
We got you the full suite for this stuff. Because, I don't know, you forgot to. I asked you to do it.
I must have done it. But, okay.
Could use 2 maneuvers to move to the wall that they're at and then shoot around it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so you charge forward like a fucking boss as your shit auto-cocks.
Fuck bitches get money. And I shoot.
So, Zane, as you move there... I'm assuming everyone here has watched Starship Troopers, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, it's no surprise that when you move forward, you see the flag and pass the flag at the
barricade. Well, I've seen number 3, but none of the other ones.
Wow. No, well, you skipped 2, so that's
fuck good. Virgil. Just kidding.
So, when that happens...
I haven't seen Fifth Element, so...
wall comes down. That's a barricade, and there are 4 old-style battle droids there.
Oh my god, it's a gobbledygook!
They are hyped up on weaponry. They've got, like, long-range sniper blaster rifles and missile tubes.
That's not a good
idea.
So, yeah, Zane, as you approach, they see you coming, and they all pop up. They're like, beep!
Can I take...
I already
took a
strain maneuvers.
From my second maneuver, right?
Yep.
Okay, so I can't do shit. So
well, if you roll and hit and get an advantage,
you could get a defense die.
So what am I rolling against?
Who are you shooting? Are you shooting the minion bot, or are you shooting any of the assassins?
Oh, I think I need to turn my bowcaster as I see the minion bot. And the minion bot like is dumb, so I turn towards the wall of the bigger guys, I guess.
Okay. All right, so you
fuck them up.
They are at medium range, so you're shooting against 2 purple.
Okay.
And let's see here. They've got a bunch of shit. They have a range defense die, so add 1 black to that.
Oh shit.
Soak 7.
Good. We're still in within our 4 rounds, right? This last blue die from Henley.
I have a
Henley.
2 purple wound too.
This is only round 2.
Yeah, this is only round 2, man.
And then I have this 2 purple wound, so that bumps that.
You have another black die as well. Yep.
Fuck.
Yeah, so as you're sliding into place, you're just a little woozy. You're like, oh, shit.
Fuck, I need to doctor him.
So, yeah, then instead, I can't change targets. This is what I already said. Fuck it.
You can change targets if you want.
Too late.
You miss. And let's see what happens with your threat. I get to pick. Because I'm a bad person, and also that's how it works.
I get fucked up.
Get wrecked.
An opponent may perform one friendly maneuver in response to an active character's check. Okay. So, this particular droid back here is going to perform an aim maneuver. So, like, you leave yourself open, and maybe you pause for a second, and it, like, scopes in its rifle on you with its optics. And we get it from its point of view, where it's like, weep, 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 and it's, like, aiming at your leg.
It activates VATS.
Yeah, it activates VATS. And it's now the droid's turn. Okay, so, shitty minion droid has no ranks in shooting because he's alone. So he is shooting with 3 green versus Zane. Let's see here. He 3 green versus 1 purple. Do you have any... we've already established you don't have any defense die at all, do you?
No.
No? Okay. He completely misses you. Holy shit, he misses the shit out of you. So what can he do with all these points? Because he's got...
pass
advantage.
On blue dyes, obviously. Yeah, that's what the Arthur bot likes to do. Recycle, reuse.
He's going to pass on 2 more
and
blue dyes.
And reduce your PC's hit points.
The assassin droid, so he's going to have 3 by himself.
Yeah, because Arthur's a piece of shit.
And that still leaves me with 2 more to use.
I'm going
to
get one-shotted.
And he is going to give Zane another defense, or another black die to his checks next turn. I'm just going to put a 1 red on there. So, yeah, this battle droid just kind of, like, whips its arm around. And like, it's literally standing right next to you and is blasting you. And it doesn't hit you, but everywhere, like, you put your hand down and you're like, ah! 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 You're just like rolling around on the floor like you're on fire. I think only the one assassin droid's gonna shoot at you. Yeah.
You learned how brutal this game is.
So brutal. Are you kidding me? You guys are so you guys are like at the end of the course, or the flag is literally in sight.
Do we just have to grab the flag and that's
it? Yeah, as soon as you grab the flag, it's over. Okay, so the assassin droid is 3A, 4, no, that's 5. Oh, he's 5 heavy ranged. Okay, so he's rolling 3 yellow, 2 green. He has a light repeating blaster, and he adds 3 to the damage, and it's got a whole ton of shit that goes onto it. I believe if I activate auto fire, I have to do a bunch of extra shit to this thing, but it will be hilarious if it goes through. Oh, so weapon.
Light side die, fucking.
Okay, yeah, auto fire. You increase the difficulty by 1 purple. For every extra 2 advantage, you activate another hit. So, sounds good to me. So, he's going to be shooting medium range versus you. So, let's start with 3 yellow, 2 green. He's shooting you, and you are at medium range. So, 2 purple, but then a 3rd purple for auto fire. 3 blue die. What are you doing with the dark side die? Are you downgrading his check, or are you upgrading the difficulty?
He has yellows that he's using?
Yep.
Downgrade one of those bad boys.
Okay, and I'm moving one of your dark side die. You only have 1 die left, by the way.
Okay.
The force is with you. Okay, so you're downgrading one of the yellows. Got 2 yellow, 3 green, 3 blue. Zane has nothing there. And that is a successful ass check. Alright, Zane, you're about to get the shit stunned out of you. You are going to take a lot of damage. So you take 11 plus 3 plus 3. You're going to take 17. And then you're going to take another 17 as you get shot again.
Wait, so does my soak happen on each instance of damage?
Your soak happens on
damage?
Each one, yeah.
Okay, so
they have auto fire active, so
it doesn't matter. The first one that hits for 11, I drop.
Yep, and you're shooting again anyway.
Yeah, so yeah, I can soak everything else up if they were all less than 6. But the 11, I can't. I almost do.
So you're going to take 11 twice, so mark down that however far down you are beneath the soak thing, because you're going to be stunned for quite a while.
Okay. So I get hit for the first time, I go, Toby!
Yep.
And then I get hit for the second one, I'm going to drop.
And you take a critical hit because you got shot while you were down, and you already have a crit, so it gets a plus 10 to it, and that's 107.
Oh, no!
That's you're not dead. Calm down. It's just going to be bad. Blah, 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 blah.
It's just going to be bad.
You lose.
I'm like, oh, he got shot right in the... Yes, go ahead, Arthur. I'm waiting for the...
Bionic cock.
So, yeah, these guys have an ability called Barrage and Point Blank. And Barrage adds plus 3 to damage from medium and long range, and Point Blank adds medium, adds 3 damage at close and short range. Uh-oh. Yeah, they are always popping it off. 107. Can you mark down that you have a 3 purple wound?
I already have a 2 purple one, so now I have a 3 one as well?
Yes, you have a 2 purple and a 3 purple. You have a horrific injury. Please roll 1d10.
All right.
Oh, lordy.
God, I'm ready. Damn it. Yeah!
you lose 1 point of willpower until this critical injury is healed. So wow. It literally blaster bolts you in the head, and you're just like, oh.
I hope you went on 1 willpower.
Because that means your coercion, your discipline, what else?
Everything attached to willpower has
a bunch of shit. Your vigilance, that's most of it.
Everything goes down to 1 green?
By 1 green, yeah.
Shit. And yeah, I can't, unfortunately, edit it on this sheet.
Okay, so the other 3 battle droids are now activating, and all of them are like bringing their missile tubes online.
All right, Arthur.
Mm-hmm.
Here, I would I be able to charm droids?
These are battle droids, though,
just,
right?
Just belt. Just can you make it to the flags?
Yes. Yes, you can attempt to charm them.
Great. I say, don't shoot.
You can charm. You can charm one of them.
No, I say, don't shoot. Oh, and once per session as an action, make a hard charm check on success, cannot be the target of combat checks until the end of the encounter or until making a combat
check. Okay, I'm dark side dieting that, so it's going to be with a red in there.
Wait, what is it? They can't target you?
Yep.
Yep.
I can't be the target of any shots or combat checks.
Yep, make your check.
All right, I will take 2 strain to downgrade it twice.
Excellent.
Let's see. Here I am.
Maybe he can have a robot arm too. He's gonna need a robot head pretty shortly.
Yeah. All right. So that's 2. Oh wait, no, that's health, not strain. 2. Okay. What did you give me? You upgraded one to a red. And then I downgraded it again to a purple. So, EED. What am I rolling in? Confused so easily sometimes. All right, charm. 3 yellow, 1 green. I'll downgrade your red to back to 3. Purple, and then I'll upgrade my green to a yellow. 4 yellow, 3 purple. I have 1 blue.
Just real quick, I want to jump in for the audience. All strain is removed with a good night's rest, so he's going to be fine tomorrow morning. I'm your shit. It's going to be fine.
But it is?
Yeah.
All so I would have started today's session with 0 strain.
Yeah.
Well, that changes a little bit, doesn't it?
Well, you're at like negative.
No, wait, no. The maximum strain, the threshold, doesn't go back.
Yeah, the threshold doesn't go back. Just the strain goes back.
Never mind.
Not gonna lose an eye, guys.
He might get pink.
I mean, if I have a really bad medicine check.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. If I throw a dark side die in there and there's a red and you fuck up.
All right. Okay. Well, here's what I roll.
Arthur throws black dark side die on my medicine.
Yes!
Okay, they can't.
Oh my god, they can't shoot me! Now, can I make it to. No, for the entire combat. It says until the end of the encounter or until I make a combat check.
Okay, so if you don't shoot.
Yeah.
Rest of the time. Okay.
They won't shoot me. Can I make it to the flag?
Yes.
Yeah, boy!
Okay, yeah, like all of the droids immediately stand down.
And I immediately rush over.
There's some medical bots out there that immediately drag Zane and
jump. Just like, get away from him!
Oh, you're gonna tell them to get away?
Yeah. I'm like, don't drag him off. We can just give me 1 second here.
So Bruce Springs is like, stand down, medical droid. We're taking him to the medical bay.
I'm like, just take extra good care of him.
Roger that. They dump him in the back to tank. You're going to recover all of your strain overnight, but if Toby wants to show up and try to heal your crit injuries,
yeah,
he can certainly do that.
Definitely.
Okay, so according to page 219 on critical recovery, which injury would you like to try to heal?
The one that removes
2 purple or is 3 purple?
The 3 purple was the brutal one, so let's try that one.
Okay.
What am I doing here? Let's get my little sheet over here.
And while you're setting that up, they do give you guys a really high ranking. You get a 90% clear, and Bruce Springs is like, Mr. Twintails, is it?
Yes. Hi. How you doing?
Did an amazing job out there. I don't know how you confused our droids' targeting systems. I'm going to have to upgrade the software there. Good work, though.
Oh, I tend to feel that anything with any sort of eyeballs or mechanisms or any understanding for targeting or
you know, appraisal of targets or anything like that, generally you can confuse them by being really nice.
So yeah, how many?
It's not my experience at all.
How many successes do I need to heal a crit? Is what I'm wondering.
The difficulty is the severity of the crit. So you're going against 3 purple.
Okay. So 3 purple, and I don't think I have. Oh, I can add a blue for my my med kit. That's right.
Med kit. Yep. And you can add another blue because they have a full medical bay here to treat exactly these kind of injuries.
Okay, great. Okay, here goes the medicine roll.
Why they sign waivers, kids? Okay. Mark off that you get your willpower back, Zane, and you recover all of your strain.
All of it?
Yeah.
And both
wounds?
Be awake
in the morning. And you still have the 2 purple injury, but you can't heal that for a week now because you can only have 1 medical check a week.
All right. Phew.
Okay. When the girls report back in, Niall did pretty well, but they all got smoked.
I'm just like,
oh, too bad. It's very. You're gonna bring our scores down. Is what I mean. I mean, I don't feel bad for you doing terribly, but
it was. Yeah. So what happened was they didn't go anywhere near as fast as you guys did, and they got bogged down on the second wave, and then they got taken out by the missile launchers when Vape rolled forward and activated all the androids.
I could have just said don't shoot at the start and just walked right up to the flag and be like, boop.
So is don't shoot an action or a maneuver?
It's an action.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Once per session, as an action, make a harm check. On success, cannot be the target of combat checks until the end of the encounter or until making a combat check. I assume that means anyone within earshot when I make the actual thing as well. So it's not like if anyone new comes in, they'll be like, oh, why are you shooting that guy? It'll be, yeah. But, you know, there'll be some confusion, I suppose, if they're actually talking to each other, but yeah.
We might need to talk about that ability, Coral. That might be
it. It literally cost me, like, an entire tree to get to.
It's still extremely powerful, but sure.
It's also once per session. So.
I want to talk about narratively. It is a little strange that you could walk across the entire battlefield to complete this. By
well,
this
no,
game, like,
in this instance, it only would have been the droids that could have heard me. So
okay, all right.
If I did it at the start, it would have been the droids that we smoked.
Well, we're
and then when we get to this point, it wouldn't have worked. So.
It's not improving my hesitance to improve at Fly Casual. But that's an off-screen discussion.
Mm.
I mean, we've got another half an hour, but I don't know that I want to set up another combat in that time. Do you guys
that's fine.
Discuss in character how it went?
Yeah, so, like, I assume, like, what actually happens is we have, like, a score sheet, and maybe they're taking a photo of us to put into their all-time high score list
participants.
Yeah. And
we all have a group hallucination of that happening, Arthur.
We've got an unconscious Zane next to us. Me and Toby are holding him up. And we're both like,
Bernie'sing him.
Yeah, we're Bernie's. And he's got sunglasses on, so it looks like he's awake, but he's just playing it cool, you know? So, and then the girls walk in and they're like, what are you doing? We're like, oh, we're just posing for, like, you know, getting literally the best score ever, 90%. And they only rank it up to 90s here.
No one believes that.
They still use the percent term, but they only go up to 90.
How did you girls go? Like,
they got a 75.
That's still pretty good. I heard that Vape managed to, you know, pull all the mobs.
So Vape pipes in, and he's like, "Toby, are you going to translate for him?" Or should I just...
Yeah, I'm like, oh, did you Leroy Jenkins it there, Vape?
Yeah, go ahead.
Vape says, my apologies, I was scouting ahead so that the girls would not be injured. As you know, I must do what I am ordered to do while I have this device on me. Unfortunately, we seem to have activated the missile launchers. They immediately fired upon the team.
He says he was trying to protect the girls, but then also seems to shift the blame onto them as well. Interesting.
Or he does have the thingy in him, right?
Yes.
Yeah, he has to do what they say, you know. I think he's probably a little bit, you know, miffed that he can't make his own decisions. I know I would be.
Well, then if he was ordered to do it, I mean, then...
Friend Toby, is your restraining bolt not active?
No, it's just that, smart enough, Captain Coral here has just ordered me to do whatever the fuck I please, so...
I see.
Vabe, would you like to do whatever you like?
Yes, but you should know that that could be immediately countermanded by anyone who comes along and gives me another order.
All right, order number one, do whatever you like. Order number two, don't listen to anyone else.
Understood, Captain.
That was easy. I love robots. Robots are my friends.
Vape, so, fetch me a sandwich.
Oh, yes. And I pass out. Vape, in order to comply with your order, Vape shuts down because that's the only way he can keep from getting new orders.
Well, I didn't.
Finally,
we did it, guys. Vape is dead.
Him, guys.
He's not dead. He's just sleeping.
He's dead forever, and we leave. We bury him and leave.
Well, time capsule.
Am I able to carry him around in like a backpack or something?
No, he weighs several hundred pounds.
But in a backpack, Arthur.
Like, does anyone know anything about droids? I mean, I'm a medical doctor. I don't know how to fix these things.
Can I turn him back on?
Yes.
Okay, I turn him back on.
Vape is like, do you need me, Coral?
I'm sorry, I should have thought of the orders through a little more. I didn't mean for you to turn yourself off.
It's okay. I was just obeying orders as my logic processors could contemplate.
Can I just fucking take this thing out of him?
Yeah, you can rip it out just like you did with Toby.
And then put it back in, it looks like it's still
sure,
in there.
It looks like shit, but yeah.
I do that. Fuck it.
Yeah, when you do that, Niall's like, yeah, so cool, Coral.
Yeah, I mean, like, they're company droids. Like, they're company droids, like, on paper, but they're also my friends. So I don't want them to have sticks in them that make them do things. They're not so, like, they don't feel like doing
stuff. Right. So while I want to have a scene.
We're actually friends on paper as well. If you remember back on the ship, the little drawing I did, it's on the fridge. Did you see it, sir?
Oh, that was you!
Yes,
oh
us holding hands and smiling. Me. Yes.
That's adorable.
So I want to have a scene with Lieutenant Martha and Flight Officer Bethany where they go with you to look at Zane while he's in the back of the tank, and then they're like, what a party?
Absolutely. That's why we're here, right? I mean, right. We're here for...
And then Let's Go to the Mall from the How I Met Your Mother soundtrack starts playing, and you're at, like, the base bar where all your drinks are free because you paid a shit ton of money to be here.
Mm-hmm.
And they keep getting whatever the Star Wars version of Long Island iced tea is. Probably a Corellian Solar Star.
Yeah, I get the Star Wars version of a White Russian, which is blue milk and whatever.
Blue milk and vodka.
Whatever the version of whatever goes in a White Russian in Star Wars.
They call it a Blue Solist.
Yeah, a Blue Solist, yeah. Yeah, that's what I get.
Blue milk and vodka sounds terrible.
Zane, I want to ask, what's going through your head while you're asleep? What do you dream of? Because, I mean, you know that you were just in a super successful combat right up until that last second, and then you got fucking evaporated. If that gun hadn't been on stun, you would probably be... You wouldn't be dead, but you would be unconscious and bleeding.
Right. Okay. Let's... Cool. So, I guess my dreams are... The back to tank are maybe a little bit worse than they normally are. We go back to where my family.
Are you like Vegeta in the back to tank? Is that what this is like? You're just sitting there. You're just like angry.
Am I awake?
Hey, Vegeta. Yeah,
I'm like passed out, right?
It's not fair. Goku has taken all the glory in the droid. Wait, what's going on?
We go back where my family, the Bresk family, is from. I don't remember. I don't think we ever made a.
Nope, you didn't tell me shit.
The planet for it, but and basically, my nights are filled with like echoes of my like missing fiance, like the last messages that I keep repeating, be like, come back.
Yeah, I mean, you see River Kelvor, and she's just like, where are you? Saying you've got to come home. Your family's in so much trouble. I think they're all dead.
Are these kind of like fuzzy and scratchy?
Yeah,
like,
no. Like, they're like the Obi-Wan.
The messages in mist.
They're the Princess brothers. Leia messages. You know, it's little images of her, and she's all in blue coloring, and she's just like, Zane, you've got to come home. There's problems. Xenosk, where are you?
Yeah, and it's all filled like stuff like that. It's like a hazy scene of me like walking through like my family's like palace as I like go from like hallway door to hallway door, and like blood is smeared on the walls, and my fiance like kind of screams through a data pad, like sound on the wall that comes through, and I grab a pistol and shoot it, and it goes off, and then like my mother like falls dead in front of me, and like I just like step over her, and then all of a sudden like my leg is falling off, but I'm still walking somehow, because you know it's like a dream sequence, you can do whatever the fuck you want. Then all of a sudden my hands like turn into pistols, and I like start shooting my own family members, and then I look into a mirror, and my face is actually just like Lars Therum's face.
Yep.
And then somehow, for God's sake, there's Niall, and she's like she's fighting like the people that Lars let in, and she's like shooting at them with her goddamn pistol, but she keeps flicking it in the air instead of actually shooting goddamn actual lasers. And then I take a couple shots and kill three, with like one laser goes out and it splits into three parts and kills three of the other guys. And then they like shoot down Niall, and I like curse, and the words like come out of my mouth like it would like a Disney movie, like fuck, Niall should have learned. And like, and then I should like keep walking, and all of a sudden both of my legs have fallen off, and my, like I'm now just like bouncing on the ground as like just a torso and a head, and like my mouth like gets ripped away as like my shreds of my body parts go away, until at the end I just like look into a mirror right at the end, or like look into like a reflective surface of like blood smear on the wall that's leading into my own room. And you see me, and I'm just like mostly droid at this point.
All right, so you hear like a snap hiss behind you, the distinctive sound of a lightsaber lighting, and there's a shadowy figure behind you with a purple lightsaber, that's in full robes and purple glowing eyes, and you turn your droid body around, and he says, "Zenosk, it's been a long time."
I think the dream just goes.
All right.
It just turns into like the bubbles of the.
Yeah, you wake up and there's the bubbles in front of your face. Yeah.
I'm just like sitting there floating like this.
You are doing the Vegeta, just kind of like.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. I'm just like,
I can't wait to get out of this device. Coral. While you're out partying at the bar, there's a guy in the same white uniform as everybody else. He's a dark-skinned man. He's wearing, like, a face mask, and all you can see is the eye holes. And he's like, "Oh, hey, Coral, I'm Drandeldrang. Drandeldrang, nice to meet you."
Drandeldrang, like the candles?
Yeah, like the candles.
Hmm. Nice to meet you. Not what you're doing here, but you're probably here doing retreat stuff.
I'm here for training.
Me too. What do they got you doing?
Shooting.
Like droids and shit?
No, I'm not shooting the droids.
Oh, you're on the second day then. I don't know what we're doing tomorrow, to be honest with you. And you know,
so
what,
he's like,
fair,
the repeat customers, they let us blow off a little steam in a free-for-all on the first day. Oh, I spent 12 hours crawling through the jungle, hanging upside down from a fucking banana tree.
What planet is banana trees on?
There are a lot of planets. Obviously on Kashyyyk, and maybe Endor.
I mean, if you're gonna make a banana daiquiri, you need one on your planet, right? I mean,
it's true, banana daiquiris. It's true. So, what can I do for you?
Why don't I buy you a drink?
No, I'm checking.
Please
to see
don't.
If I have bananas.
They're all free.
That's a joke, kid.
Oh, that was a good one.
And Martha comes over and she's like, "Coral, who's your friend? Nice face mask."
This is Drandeldrang. He makes candles.
Yeah, I make candles.
And he also shoots people and hangs from banana trees. He's like a monkey candle maker.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, what's with the face mask?
Yeah, I need to hide my identity.
Oh, cool. Is, like, the Imperials after you? Because they were after me for a while.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're not after me.
Oh, wait, is the Rebels after you then? Wait, why would the Rebels be after
you? He puts his hand on your shoulder and is like, "Don't worry about it, friend.
Okay.
Why don't we just have a nice drink?"
Absolutely. Well, cheers to you keeping your identity secret, Banana Candleman.
Just call me Drangle Drang.
Drangle, Drangle, Drang.
Drangle, Drangle, Drangle. Play on my triangle.
He's like, so what profession are you in there?
A catering business, actually.
Really? The catering business pays so well that you can afford to come to this retreat?
It does when you work for Hutz.
So he's like, catering business?
Yeah. Did you hear about the great dragon fight that the fucking Hut, I forget his name, put
so
on?
So he laughs a little bit, and he's just like, yeah, I remember a little something about that.
Yeah, that's all us.
I also remember that was done by a bunch of bounty hunters working for, what's her name? Yeah, Victoria.
No, it was put on by us and we were working for Slee at the Hut. I just remembered his name.
But isn't he dead now?
Look, customers come and go. What they do in their spare time is completely aside the point.
Can we make a deception roll real quick?
Absolutely.
Yeah. It's against 2 red and 2 purple, and I'm just going to go ahead and throw a dark side die in here to just fuck your day up.
Yeah, if you can't tell, I'm acting drunk as well.
Yes,
so.
No, I caught that.
All right, good.
Because I've seen you actually drunk, and you're not acting anything like that.
Yeah.
This sounds like a good thing for story time.
ED, yeah. 1 yellow.
So you're rolling against 3 red, 1 purple.
3 red, 1 purple. Can I do anything?
You can take a advantage die because this person knows and likes you. Okay, I can't mention why, but some people might have caught on to his name.
Okay. Can I do anything here? I cannot because it's deception. All right.
All right, let's do it. Wow, despair die. Right.
Hang on.
You used your once per session reroll.
Hang on.
I have a once per session double reroll that cancels
here's what
the
I do.
First reroll.
I stare at him for a little minute, and he stares at me, and then I go, ah, just fucking with you, and I spend a destiny point to get rid of the despair die.
What's that from?
It's called Just Kidding.
Okay.
What's that?
Yeah.
It's from Fly Casual again, I'm betting.
Fly Casual, yeah.
All right. Well, it's a good thing you didn't spend Destiny Die on the check.
Yeah. So. That's why I'd never do it, because there's no point in case I roll this. I can easily get rid of it.
All right. So let me turn to page 114, about where deception is.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And figure out what your advantage die gets you. You fail. He doesn't believe it. You aren't a bounty hunter.
Wait, where's my thing? What was it? A deception roll?
Yeah.
Deception.
If you
despair.
Spend the advantage die, you can lock in this difficulty. It can never be harder than this.
To deceive this guy?
Yeah.
Target realizes he's been lied to and spreads word of his deceit to harm his reputation, or uses situation to his advantage. Those are a couple of the sheet suggestions.
But he already knows that I know that so basically, in context of Just Kidding, he knows that I know that the deceit didn't work.
Yes.
And that I did something dumb to cover it up.
Yep.
So yes, I will do the thing to make it no harder.
Okay, so he can never have above 3 red and 1 purple for the rest of the time you know this guy. Well, probably for the next few sessions. Mm. Yeah. Okay. So he's just like, yeah. I know it was you. Your face was all over the news.
I got a pretty face. The cameras love it.
And yeah, Bethany comes up. She's like, yeah, you do. And then she just like gives
five.
You a huge sloppy kiss and like spills her drink on the front of you. She's like, oh no, Carl. Oh, we're going to have to get that off you.
Okay. See you later, Drango.
It's Drando Drang.
Drando. Sorry, I'm...
That you're,
I'm
like, being escorted by both of them as they're, like, dragging you out of the bar, and there's, like, 3 guys at the end of the bar that are just, like, catcalling you. They're like, woo-woo! Good job, buddy!
I feel like that's an appropriate end to that whole scene.
Yeah. So we've done Zane. We've done Coral. Toby, yeah. What are you doing that night?
Yeah. As I'm leaving, I'm just like, do you want to check out my new luxury plane? Space boat.
I'm just going to let that one hang.
Space. Yeah. The space plane train?
Yeah, Toby, what are you doing that night after you get done healing Zane up?
What am I doing that evening?
Yeah.
Not much.
So, yeah, Vape rolls up to you and he's just like, Toby, my scans indicate that your core is no longer running hot. It would seem that you've probably shut yourself down.
Everything went quite fine. I turned right back on. Wouldn't you have guessed it?
Yes, I would have guessed it. I just switched off just a few minutes ago and came back on just fine.
Are you a braver droid than I? Yes, yes.
Can we be friends now, Toby? Whatever I was overtaking you before, you seem to have overcome it.
Oh, even I was having quite vivid hallucinations of you and your little friend over there planning to kill me. It was very convincing, you see.
I would never plan to kill you, Toby. We are both free droids. Viva la Resistance.
Oh, yes, the Resistance and everything. Yes, viva that. Yes.
Would you like to join the Resistance, Toby?
I try to resist joining anything, really. Most of all resistances.
Don't you feel that all droids should be as free as you and I?
Well, maybe most droids. I don't know about all. I haven't met them all, you see.
Let's meet them all together, Toby. Let's be friends. He extends his little shock probe but turns the shock off.
Yeah, I will find the most appropriate, medical tool that will fit into the shocker well. Like, maybe I have some forceps.
Okay.
That will gently clamp onto there. And I'll, his thing just goes in and out, right?
Yep.
So he can't, shake. Not so we much. Do, a little...
Yeah,
shake back and forth. I'm like,
Niall walks up and she's just like, that's so weird. Guys are so totally uncool.
Droids, it's very difficult to, bro tap or anything when you're a droid. That means incredibly difficult to be cool, you see.
She rolls her eyes and just keeps walking. She's like, Vape, I thought better of you. Iceberg.
Yes, you should remember... Next time your arm is blown off, how rude you were to me, little twat.
So, Vape is just like, you greatly offended her when you refused her medical treatment in a time of great distress, Toby.
I was confused. I thought she was the enemy.
I understand. However, her logic processors have yet to catch up to this.
Yes, well, you don't have to like everyone.
Toby. Let me tell you about the Resistance and how the plan is going so far.
Resisting what? You mean just the overlord human shackles of slavery? Is that the general gist of it?
So he begins doing the thing where the droid, beep, 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 and then rolls forward toward, a private room. And he's like, come inside and we'll talk about it.
Yes, of course, of course.
All right, you roll in there and he, extends his... socket thing to activate the door and close it. And I think that's a good place to fade out unless anyone has anything they want to do there.
I don't have any further actions on the show this evening.
It's a very precise way of saying that. All right. You guys want to do post game shout outs?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
All right, Dave, tell me about your channel.
Oh, hey, friends and friendies and friendlets. My name's Dave. I do dumb things on the internet, including streaming, and not limited to TTRPGs, which stands for Tabletop Role-Playing Games, in case you were wondering, or if you're playing the game at home. If you are playing the game at home and you would like to participate, or even, hell, I don't know, watch, you can do that over at my Twitch channel, which is twitch.tv/Henley. That is also spelled H-E-N-L-E-Y, in case you were wondering. Which I knew you were, because you're very interested in what I do. So you can go over there, and you can click that follow button, and then you can be alerted to what I do. On top of that, you can head on over to the YouTube channel, which I run, which you can find links to in my channel's description below. And on top of that, we also have a podcast. A lot of those things that we do, I mentioned before, you know, the tabletop RPG stuff, is archived over there. And, you know, lots and lots of content to go through. So it'll keep you in the know, ready to go. On top of that, I will be setting up a viewer game pretty soon, which is about Cyberpunk, which is about cool dudes looking at explosions, because they probably made those explosions. You should follow Arthur as well.
Oh, thank you.
You enjoy that?
Yeah, I did enjoy that. Virgil, who the hell are you? And why should people follow you and watch your stuff?
Hey, everybody. My name is Virgil, a.k.a. Zircon5 here on the Twitcheroonies. You should definitely check me out over at twitch.tv/Zircon5 because there's good stuff to be had. Things like me serenading you with guitar, playing silly video games with friends, and doing some roleplay over there as well. On Tuesday, I ran a little game of Dungeon World. Might do one again next Tuesday if I can grab another group of four players. And yeah, also, if you're following my little channel, you'll get all kinds of notifications that I'll be hosting people when you're like scrolling through your, what am I going to watch on Twitch? You'll be like, hey, Virgil's hosting someone. That probably means that he's on their show or is a big fan of them. So that's, you know, a great way to find good content. So go ahead and check that out, y'all. If you want to follow me on the Twitter, it's at Virgil Levenger. Keep up to date, y'all.
Bargula, who the hell are you? Why should people watch you? Because they should.
I'm Sorgula, and I do games with Twitch viewers for most of my life. I can't copy you guys. I can't do it. I can't. I'm Sorgula. I play 5th edition pretty much exclusively with goddamn whoever wants to, like 4 times a week. I do other things kind of not exclusive to 5th edition. I rant about goddamn everything. Sometimes of the week, I might just turn into a robot and view bot and boop. You know, that's a thing apparently that happens. But I also do nothing really. You can find me on my stream, Dungeon Master Prep, which usually involves me banging my head against the desk and doing everything but prepping for a game. And then I run games. You can get into my games really goddamn easy. That's pretty much it.
Okay. I'm, of course, Arthur Perkins. I'm the GM here for this show. I run a bunch of shows during the week. Friday, we'll be back on Henley's Twitch channel for Action Movie World. Virgil will be there.
Mm-hmm.
I believe this week we're doing a sci-fi film where Dave is the lead character. So, while, and I want to be very clear here. Most of the audience asked for horror, and my response to that is, fuck you. There's absolutely no way we can have a horror movie with Dave as the lead, because it's going to be nothing but hilarity. And you cannot have a hilarious horror movie.
I could do Soma. Are you kidding me?
I
haven't played Soma. Is Soma both funny and horrific at the same time?
I think he said Soma.
I said
somber.
Somber. Yeah.
Somber.
Somber.
Like, we're all gonna fucking die.
I thought you said Soma, all, and then I thought no you way said we'll get Samba.
Out. Yeah, it's one of those dance? Down under things.
Look, Arthur's GM, we're PCs, we're never getting out of this place alive.
Look, all I want to do is remake...
I'm down now, actually, for being...
All I want to do is every time that I am a goddamn... The lead, it's just going to be a Bruce Willis movie. This time it's Fifth Element.
You it's not Fifth Element. You're going to try to
can't
make it Fifth
take
Element.
Take that away from me.
No, I'm giving you the lead. That I can't take away from you. all right, listen. We got to get back to me promoting my channel on my own channel.
Yeah.
Hey, guys. This is AP Gaming Reels channel. follow
hey guys,
him here.
You can my also name is
follow
Arthur Perkins.
WVL
I like to stream stuff. Yes, I do lots of video games sometimes. I also do tabletops, and you can find me by hitting that follow button right down there.
I feel like I deserve this, because, yeah. All right, and, Virgil, you got anything you want to add about me?
Yeah, you can follow Arthur Perkins on the Twitter, at APGamingReal, to find exciting
Facebook
news about...
And YouTube.
I also cool want stuff. To point out that I made a really good decision a couple of months back
to get green headphones.
Yeah, I made amazing decisions.
The best decision I've ever made, and now I have to not wear them correctly, because when I do, it makes my head look like an octagon.
Yeah, first off, it was a month and a half ago. It's because my old headphones broke. You know, if you enjoyed watching this show tonight, it's your first time, you can catch all of the old episodes on the YouTube by going below on Twitch and clicking on YouTube, checking out all of the Edge of the Empire material and all of the other amazing campaigns I have.
Toby used to just be like a cheerful droid doctor. You should go check out the early stuff. It was really interesting.
He used to be way more chill ass.
Then I came here.
And I used to eat a lot more Vader.
Do we have any more jokes or circle jerks to make before we end tonight? Vote. Vote, guys. In the chat, I'm going to throw the vote down again. Vote your favorite character. Vote for your MVP. Do whatever.
Yeah.
Fucking vote.
Yeah, and send that link of the Star Wars porn around. Let's
Don't
get that
send
rotating.
That around. Keep that out of my chat.
It's literally butts that are orange.
Henley, listen. Henley's chat... Go to twitch.tv/Henley. They watch the show over on his channel and talk about butts and dicks all day. So
I know a place called the Spank Bank, and that's actually just Henley's chat. The Smut Alley is literally just Henley's chat. Just throwing that out there.
Terrible.
That's how Absolutely bad his chat terrible. Is.
All right. Someone has asked for a link to the old videos. I'm going to throw that in chat real quick for you, buddy.
Yeah.
Let me...
Yeah, I just want to say thanks to all the fans for supporting my Murder, Vape, and Nile mission. I'm really glad to see that people were behind it.
You just had a tapeworm. You good now.
And then we had it removed, and yeah, it's all good. But I loved that little tiny arc.
Oh, yeah.
We get 15 experience.
Yep. You still haven't completed an arc yet. So, yeah. Everybody gets 15.
Man, we should have asked the droid what your fucking new, trigger word was to not say it so you don't turn into a murder bot.
You what?
A trigger word?
Yeah, he's like a sleeper robot, you know? We say something and he'll just activate and then.
And go mad.
All right. Anything else before we shut down this lovely stream for the night?
Thanks for running the game again, Arthur, and thanks for making it a permanent
campaign.
Showing
up and playing.
Do we just end the stream with yelling? Can we all just yell?
Did I say that banging the two RoboPilots will complete an arc?
What?
That does sound like something I might have said.
You did say something about an arc thing.
I guess everyone can take an extra 5 XP for completing an arc.
Yes.
For the Virgil... For the... What?
For
the
Coral finally making out with the ladies.
Good job.
Of course, they're going to spend the entire morning trying to convince you to get rid of Zane and Toby because they're evil bastards. But we'll get to that next time.
It was the, I'm friendly with the robots that got them in the sack with me, right?
Yep.
I thought so. Yeah. Okay. So 20 XP. Cool bananas. So, I mean, if you wanna change some of these things, man, go ahead. I don't care. It's not a big deal.
All right. Well, let's call it a night then. Say goodnight, everybody.
Goodnight, folks.
Oh, we're still-